Hello. So till now we have seen the basics of workbench, engineering data and geometry cell. So which can be seen over here, and the same are available in the model. So the model is the one cell which will open in a new window, which is NCS Mechanical, which I'll open now in some time. And the setup, solution and results all are combined in the same cell. So this is one of the most important window for you to understand all the basics, shortcuts to save your time, get your hands-on experience, everything while doing your project. So there are multiple panels over here, and let's start with it. So when you go to NCS, we had the geometry file being updated, which was the nut. And when you update a geometry file or import a geometry file, click on refresh and click on update. Then you go to model, right click on it and go to edit. Otherwise, you can directly double click on the model and it will open a mechanical APDL. So that is the solver mechanical APDL, and that is the background processor, which is the APDL processor. And for your interface, it will open a mechanical screen like that. So if you have replaced the geometry, so if I go to geometry and replace the geometry by some other geometry, and then if you want to work again on the model, then it is recommended you update the upstream components first, then click on update. So it will update the upstream components like geometry and engineering data, then it will update itself. So the in the model, that is the mechanical, it will update. So there were the options which we can play around. Now coming to the workbench mechanical file. So you can read the mechanical, which is the mechanical solver. We have come over here and our file has been imported. The details, so let's just name the panel. So this is the top menu panel. Then this is the shortcut panel or view or selection panel. So we can change the views, we can change the selection options from here. Then this is the left panel, which is the tree, the project outline. And here we have the details. So these are the four main panels. And this is a working window. And just to name, this is an interface or graphical user interface for a mechanical window. There is another option where we can go to NCS APDL, which is the actual mechanical solver, which solves whatever equations which are there on the backhand side of this, this NCS mechanical part. So that the APDL part was the first introduced much earlier, and the graphical user interface has been updated recently. So let's go over here. In the left panel of the tree, we have outline. So in the outline, we have the model A4 and B4. Why the A4 and B4 has come over here? It is because the A is over here, the A module, the A project, the project number B. In project number A, we have model. Project number B, we have model. Both are linked. So both are combined over here. Then we have geometry. So whatever the geometry was here, it has been imported over here. I'll explain the different kinds of symbols which are shown over here. Then we have the materials. So whatever materials we had added earlier, that was the three materials, AISI 1020, which we added by our own. Silane was the one which we imported from the engineering data source or the NCS library. Structural steel was the one which was already given by NCS engineering data. Then we have coordinate system. So that is imported from the geometry file. Connections are made itself by NCS workbench. Mesh, we have to work on the mesh. The next part are the boundary conditions and constraints. Then we go to solution. The steady state thermal is being shown over here because both were connected. So we'll just click on the minus button or collapse all the options we have. So let's start with the geometry. So I'll explain the different symbols now. The question mark symbol means it is incomplete. The incompleteness will be shown by a yellow tab. So it is yellow. All other things are white in background. The cells are white in background. The assignment is not completed because there were multiple materials available. Now if I click on structural steel, now it is white. So it has been completely assigned. The material has been assigned. It has turned to white background. And over here in the outline also, it has turned to a tick mark, a green tick mark. Then in the materials, we can see that the three materials are listed down. The structural steel, whatever properties, value of the properties it had. The AISI which we added, so there were limited number of properties we added. CLEN was the one which was imported from the library. The coordinate system is shown. So coordinate system, local coordinate system is over here, which was from the geometry file. And this is the coordinate system from ANSYS workbench. Then we have connections. Connections means the various contacts like a frictional contact, permanent joint, a bonded contact. So there are, we can import different contacts and we'll go to details of these connections later. Then we have mesh. So mesh is the process in which we'll change a continuous system. So this is a 3D model, a continuous system. Go to the basics where we have continuous points over there in our geometry. And if we have number of points, so over here we have infinite number of points on our 3D geometry file. If we want to solve this, what's the meaning of solving is when we apply some force, the force equations comes into picture. What does that mean? There is a force applied and there will be displacement. So force, displacement and material properties get involved. Since we have infinite number of points, the force will be applied to infinite number of points and we want the result as displacement or stress on those points. So there will be infinite numbers of results. So we cannot have infinite everywhere. The solver gets crashed every time when we have infinite number of points. So meshing is the process in which we'll convert the infinite number of points into finite number of points by making or choosing a small area, a collection of points as one single element. And that single element will be described as that center of point of that element will be assigning the whole number of whatever close number of points, like some mm's or some feet, some micrometers, etc. That's the process we have to understand in meshing. So what's the actual process? How many number of points will be collected to single point? How many number of nodes or how many number of elements will be generated? And then here we have, so this is the common things which will be applied to static structural AFI. So why it is saying AFI is over here? Because setup AFI and the steady state thermal part, which is B5. So both are open because both were linked and they'll have the same mesh, coordinate system, connections, materials. What's the change we can have over here is the constraints and boundary conditions will be changed. In static structural, we can add different loads, and in steady state thermal, we can have different kinds of loads. So that's the difference we'll have over here. So we can import loads and we can insert different kinds of forces. So the forces are because of the static structural part, and the loads which we see over here are the temperature loads or heat loads, which are because of the steady state thermal part. So we have seen the left panel, the outline. This was the most important part. Then at every time we clicked on a different cell or different module, the outline or the details got changed. So when we go to each of those things, the details are going to change. So this is very, very important. Then let's go to menu bars. So over here, we have the home, which has all the different tools for us. Since we have selected coordinate system, the coordinate system has appeared on the menu bar. If we go to geometry, the geometry gets appeared. If we go to mesh, the mesh gets appeared. So this is the working selection window for you. If you want to use the options from here, we can use the options from here. So mesh has the different options and the same options will be available over here. So if you right click on mesh, you get all the different options, whichever you see on the top panel. So insert, so we have method sizing, whatever methods we have, the same is over here. So I am more used to use this right left panel for my work, and I'll be using that during the videos. If you are good, if you're good to go with using this top panel, that's also fine. Some things are better at the top panel, some things are better at the bottom panel, like the left panel. Then we have display, so we can display the things, cross-section, display style can be body type, body color, etc. Then we can display the wireframe. So the wireframe is shown but the wireframe model is being used less by the project developers because there are some confusions. We cannot understand that this line is crossed by this, right? But this line is at the top or bottom. So that cannot be understood easily. That's why the 3D model is the best one. Then we have selection. So since we do not have any special selections right now, they are all suppressed or frozen. And in automation, we have a scripting thing, whatever similar things which we have seen in geometry. We have run macro and object generators over here. We can copy paste a set of commands. We have made some for mesh or boundary conditions. The same set can be copied to different number of selections like edges or planes, etc. So that is what object generator does. So let's come to the selection window, that is the shortcuts. So here we can show the different kinds of models, wireframe model. Then if you have generated the mesh, this is the option to show the mesh, then rotate the view. So this is how we can rotate. Then we can pan, zoom. So these are the options to zoom. I'm just scrolling using my mouse scroll button. Then I can zoom in. Then I can zoom out, zoom to fit. So it may happen that if your geometry file is in having dimensions or units as meters, and if your ANSYS workbench geometry or the model over here is using unit system some other, then your file will be very small. If even though you cannot find where is your geometry, and you will say your geometry is not imported. This is because your the unit system are not consistent. For that part, you just need to click over here, zoom to fit, and if there is some model available, it will be automatically shown to you. Then we have different selection modes, like we can know single select and box select. So single select means we can select each edge like this, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the edges selected are shown in green. We can go to box select, and it will select multiple, all the edges which are concerned with that box. So there are two ways we can start a box. If we start a box from the right and go to left, it will select all the edges which are going to come on the box, even though the edges are not complete. That means, let me zoom in over here and let me make a box which is very small like this. So it is not covering this complete edge, but since it was started from left, right and brought towards left, the complete edge has been selected. If I go and select it from the left and drag it towards the right, it will not select that. This is because those are the two different modes of selection. The left to right box will select only the edges which are completely inside that box. So this will not select that edge, but if I select it completely, then it is going to select that edge. So this is very important for you. Then we have different selections of nodes, edges, face, bodies. And if I made the mesh completely, then we can select nodes. So these were vertices. Then we can select node, element faces, coordinate system, labels, clipboard, extend. So this is when we are going to select multiple. So if I select this one face in single select, and I want to extend it to limits, then it will extend appropriately. Then we can select it by location, size, invert the selection. We can convert. So there are other options very much similar to what we had seen over there. We can insert according to what cell we are in. So if we are in the geometry, we can insert some different things. If we are in mesh, we can insert the according features. When we can go to option, isometric view, we can restore to defaults, and multiple options are available. If we have geometry which is having an assembly instead of a part, so here we have single part. If we had an assembly, then we can hide a single part. We can show some selected number of parts and hide different other parts. So the different options are available. In the next video, we'll start with the the geometry and all the details over there. So till then you keep exploring and looking at all the options we have discussed in this video. Thank you.